Final Cut Pro comes with a couple of built-in overlays to help you frame your video, a titled Action Safe Zones overlay and a Horizon overlay. These can be helpful, but they do leave a lot to be desired. The Horizon overlay, for example, comes with two non-adjustable guidelines running through the middle of your frame. If you're trying to use this to level out a video clip where the horizon isn't perfectly in the middle, using this overlay can still be a little tricky. But if you're running Final Cut Pro version 10.4.9 or later, you have the ability to add your own custom overlays that can make framing your video or even adding titles much easier. And that's what we'll take a look at today. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. In this video, we'll be taking a look at using custom overlays in Final Cut Pro. First, we'll take a look at how to use custom overlays in Final Cut Pro, and after that, we'll take a look at how you can make your own custom overlays using Motion 5. If you don't have Motion, or don't have time to make your own, I've put together my own custom overlay pack that you'll be able to download and use in Final Cut Pro. Let's get started. I'm sure you all know what the rule of thirds is. You take your video frame, divide it into three equal parts horizontally and vertically, and place the focal point of the video clip at one of these intersections. If you try and reframe your shot to follow this rule, it's kind of a guessing game. This is where overlays come in handy. You can either make your own overlays using Photoshop, Motion 5, or something similar, or you can download the custom overlays pack I made and use one of mine. At the top of the viewer window, open the view drop-down menu, select Choose Custom Overlay, and Add Custom Overlay. Navigate to the Custom Overlays folder and select the Thirds Grid Basic Overlay file. Click Open. An overlay pops up over the viewer window, which you can use for reference to reframe your shot. This overlay is only visible in Final Cut Pro, so you don't have to worry about seeing it in your exported video. It's just there for reference. After reframing your shot, to remove this overlay, open the View drop-down menu again and deselect Show Custom Overlay. Another use for overlays is if you need to deliver your video in a number of different formats, like 16:9 for YouTube and a vertical format for mobile platforms. Final Cut Pro has great built-in social cropping tools that allow you to easily convert your video to vertical or square video format. The only issue you might run into is if you use any titles or graphics in your video. If not placed properly, they might get cropped off when you convert your video to a different format. To help you with proper placement, you can use a vertical or a square video overlay. Open the View drop-down menu and add a custom vertical video overlay. This will cover any parts of your clip that will get cropped off when you convert your video. You can change the opacity of this overlay by hovering over the Show Custom Overlay option in the View drop-down menu and selecting one of the opacity values. You can now position any titles or graphics you have in your video without having to worry about them being cropped off. Now, to convert this project to vertical video, all you have to do is right-click on the project in the media browser, select Duplicate Project As, and select the format you want to convert your project to. And if you select the Smart Conform checkbox, Final Cut Pro will analyze your clips and reframe each clip to center it on the action. So that's just a couple uses for custom overlays. Now, let's take a look at how you can make your own custom overlays for use in Final Cut Pro. Open up Motion and make a new project. Since we only need to make a still image, the only setting that matters here is the project resolution. Set this to whatever you use in Final Cut Pro. I'll set mine to 4K for this example. First, let's make a grid overlay we used in the first example for the rule of thirds grid. Set your canvas to fit the viewer window, open the Shapes drop-down menu, and select the Line tool. Click and drag out a line anywhere in the viewer window. With a line layer selected, open the inspector, select the Properties tab, and center the line in the viewer by changing both position values to 0. Select the Shape tab and click on Geometry. We'll adjust these values to make this line vertical and run from the top of the frame all the way to the bottom. All these values are calculated from the anchor point, which is exactly in the middle of the frame. To make our line vertical, change both X values to 0. Now, our frame is 2160 pixels tall, so to make this line go all the way up to the top, we need to enter half of that, which is 1080 for the 0.1 Y value, and negative 1080 for 0.2. Let's go back to the Properties tab, and move this line over to divide our frame into thirds. Our image is 3840 pixels wide, divide that by 3, gives you 1280. Now remember, we're working from the anchor point, which is in the middle, so to divide the screen into three equal parts, we need to split that number in half, which gives us 640. Change the X position value to negative 640 to move this line to the left third of the frame. Let's make another line for the right side. Right-click on the line layer in the layers window and select duplicate. To move this line to the right side, select the properties tab and change the X value to positive 640. To make vertical lines, duplicate one of these line layers again, select the properties tab and rotate this line by 90 degrees. Change the X value to 0, and to move this line to the top third of the screen, enter 360 for the Y value. Select the Shape tab, and in the Geometry section, change the Y values to 1920 and negative 1920 to make this line go all the way across. Duplicate this layer, and change the Y position value to negative 360. Now you have a rule of thirds grid. To use this grid as an overlay in Final Cut Pro, we need to export this grid as a still image with an alpha channel, meaning the background will be transparent. Click the Share button in the top right corner and select Save Current Frame. If you don't see this option, click Add Destination and drag the Save Current Frame destination over to the left hand side. Hit the Share button again and select Save Current Frame. Give your file a name, and in the settings window, change the file type to PNG image and make sure the color and alpha channels are selected. Hit next and select your save destination. Your file is exported as a PNG image with a transparent background that can now be imported and used in Final Cut Pro as a custom overlay. Let's make one more overlay for vertical video. Go back to Motion and make a new project. Set your canvas to fit the viewer window, and since we're working with black bars to see exactly what's going on, let's make our background transparent. Open the Color drop-down menu and change this to transparent. Next, from the Shape drop-down menu, select a rectangle and drag out a rectangle in the viewer window. In the Inspector, select the Properties tab and zero out the X and the Y position values to center this in the frame. Select the Shape tab and change the Fill Color to black. Next, we need to resize this rectangle to cover the whole screen. So select Geometry, click the Disclosure Triangle for size, and change the width and the height to match your frame resolution. To make a vertical video cutout, let's use a rectangle mask. Under the Viewer window, open the Mask drop-down menu and select a rectangle mask. Drag out a rectangle in the Viewer window, and in the Inspector, select the Invert Mask checkbox. Go to the Properties tab and center your mask. Go back to the mask controls and open the size drop-down menu. We want this to match the height of our frame, so enter 2160 for height, and to make it a 16:9 aspect ratio, enter 1215 for width. Export this as a PNG image, just like we did before. And that's how you make custom overlays using Motion. You can also do the same thing in Photoshop, Pixelmator, or pretty much any other image editing app. If you can't or don't have time to make your own custom overlays, you can download and install the ones I made. Click the link in the video description and download the custom overlays pack from my website. Install one of these overlays using Final Cut Pro, then to save time, from the View drop-down menu, select Choose Custom Overlay and Reveal in Finder. Command-click the rest of the files in the downloaded folder and copy and paste them into this Finder location. When you go back to Final Cut Pro, all these overlays will be there, ready for use. All these custom overlays are completely free to download and use. They're not that hard to make, so I wouldn't feel right charging people money for them. If you find these overlays or some of my other content helpful and would like to support my channel, consider supporting me on Patreon. I'll link it in the video description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.